All right, good morning, everybody. We're going to Seneca, New York for going to State Park there, and then we're going to go to Watkins Glen and do the Falls Trail. Be meeting up with Kurt just outside of Williamsport, and then we're going to travel together up the rest of the way. See you guys there. This is absolutely beautiful. Now, distance, you can see the town. That's Geneva, New York. And yes, by the people standing out there, the water's not deep, apparently. I've been getting a kick out of that, looking around and seeing people just walking around out in the lake. Definitely not deep, for sure. This is a big, huge park. It's absolutely beautiful here. All the way down to the water here. There's a bunch of ducks and stuff up that way too. Honk, honk.
Guys, oh my gosh, I'm not sure how I feel about being this close.
There's only a couple. It's only like 20 or 30. You can see over to the city. Even better from here. Right there. Man, that sun's hot.
No.
That guy's got the right idea. And those guys, too. And next up, we're going to head down to the marina. This trail's really nice. These trees are huge. Especially this one right here. It's a big boy. See if we can catch up to Kurt. Said he's down here at the marina, and I see a lot of boats over that way, so we should find him shortly. There's a whole other parking lot over there yet.
How big is this place?
Huge.
I mean, I know it's huge.
Bigger than I thought it was going to be, that's for sure. I was looking at the map. It doesn't look big on the map, but it's big. I think what throws it off is because of how big the lake is. Mm-hmm. Because I want to say the lake is like 2 miles wide up at this end, because mm-hmm. this is the wide end of the lake.
Yeah.
And I want to say the lake is like 35 or 40 miles long. Huh. Ooh. There's a boat out there with multicolored sails. Let's see if I can actually get it on video. Well, yes, I can. Yes, I can.
I don't know how far up he is or out of sight.
No, we'll find him. Thankfully, it's not hot today. Just under the sun.
Yeah, no, if you're not under the sun, it doesn't feel bad, but under the sun, it's
very the sun, it sucks.
Yeah, that's
this
bad.
This is what happened to us when we went to Wildwood the other week. Mm-hmm. When we were walking in Wildwood, it felt like this in the shade, but we got out in the sun.
And it just felt like it was 100 degrees.
And we were just baking the whole time then.
Yeah.
And both of us ended up getting really dehydrated.
Yeah, that's bad.
And even though we had drinks with us and we were drinking.
Yeah. That's not good for any of you, including the dogs. If you guys got dehydrated, I can only imagine, you know, for the fluffs. That's cool.
Oh, yeah. So the nice part is, with me videoing right now, because I'm recording as we're walking.
Great.
As we're walking along, I can snap pictures. Mm-hmm. And I can screen grab too, which is nice. Still haven't located a Curtis though. Come down here. There's a better view down here of that bridge. You got a straight on shot right here. All right, made it to the marina. This is pretty cool. There's an old boat. Smells like an old boat. That's pretty cool looking out. You can see sailboats and everything out there.
Yeah.
I think it's just an old motor. Like it, you can see the bridge even better yet.
I can't tell he's saying what.
Yes, they're herding some ducks for us. Herd's on his way. Ducks on their way, too. Huh?
Oh boy.
And then she
to the ground.
What's up, bud?
Hi, buddy.
Alright. At Finger Lakes Visitor Center. Up here's the I Love New York sign. The lake. We're actually in downtown Geneva now. Drove down the road a little bit. Geneva's actually right over in here. There's the parking lot. Alright, here we are at Watkins Glen, and Kurt being a goofball, like usual. Oh, it looks a little low down there. Looks like it's hardly even flowing. This is the beginning part of Watkins Glen. Looking straight up at the gorge. Up ahead you can see the first bridge. Pretty neat seeing the rocks, the formations going on at the stream cut. Pretty cool. Alright, coming up on the first waterfall. Kind of see it there a little bit. Surprised it's flowing, but how low this creek is. I've seen videos here before, and I've never seen the water this low. There's usually more water flowing than this. Alright, first waterfall. It goes right underneath a bridge. Pretty neat. Like there's almost like a little cave up there too. Into the little tunnel, cave, and up some steps. Temperature's definitely dropping, that's for sure. And some more steps. And then the bridge is right there already. That was actually pretty quick. Alright. So I made it past the first waterfall. Up there's the second and third. Getting some pictures of that here in a minute. So far we did, I don't know, 60 or 70 steps, maybe more. Definitely quite a few. Better view of both of them. That's neat. There you can see where rocks kind of ground out in a perfect circle, like a whirlpool.
that waterfall's neat. You can actually go behind it. I'm going to go behind it and get some video of it and then probably head back down because it's starting to get late. It's going on 7 o'clock already. Down here you can see the erosion that's going on. That's pretty cool. The big boy waterfall there behind me. That's probably a good 40 or 50 feet at least. You can see the people behind me. They look tiny next to it. This is definitely pretty cool. We're running out of time though. It's already going on 7 o'clock like I said earlier. So this will be the last one. I'll be wrapping it up. I definitely want to come back here again for sure, but I think I want to start up at the top and come all the way down. That way I get to see all the waterfalls, not just some of them, and then have to rush home. But that's why we come back.